This is John Paul Roy. I'm coming from Tokyo, Japan. Some people call me. I got a cold, but we're pushing through, and this is a very, very disturbing story about someone who you could consider a little bit crazy, who's running Star Wars social media, and it's by The Bleeding Fool, written by Ichibaka, who also runs Disney Star Wars is Dumb. So let's take a look, and quick shout out to Josiah Rises, because I saw this story that he covered it. Okay, here we go. Here we see, Bleeding Fool, is a crazy person running the Star Wars social media account. By Ichibaka, September 11, 2019, meet Michelle Buckman, who runs social media for Star Wars. Michelle has a bold message for Kathleen Kennedy. DCR is a woman who got started as a producer, then writer, then director of a few shorts and feature, and now a huge blockbuster. See, it can be done, Kathy Kennedy. Your move, Lucasfilms. I don't really think that Kathleen Kennedy needs to be reminded she wants to hire more women. That's exactly what Kathleen Kennedy has been saying for like the last 4 or 5 years anyway. Before I get aid by everyone saying hire the best director regardless of gender, I agree. But you assume that's a world where both genders are hired equally. That's not the case, and USC did a data-driven study to prove it. Systematic hiring bias is real. Okay, I guess. But then we have down here, female filmmakers. If you want to see women get hired, that's cool, but I don't know, it just seems like the attitude is just like, yeah, say. Say it in like an intellectual way at least. Michelle cheerled for females, but she isn't a big fan of white men. And she's white, by the way. And I see everybody who's criticizing whites are white. It doesn't make sense. Why? What are they? I don't get it. Like, if a black person, well, okay, there was that one black director, that one case, but like, most of the time they're white, so if like a black person or Chinese person like seriously said it like in an intellectual way, I'd be like, yeah, maybe they feel like they're left out or something. But if white people say it, I don't really understand why all these whites are against whites. It just makes you look like a white knight. It doesn't make it look sincere. It makes you look like a social justice warrior. Insert film title here. Insert problematic director who is already canceled. Here winning top prizes at Insert That Problematic Festival, which largely ignores work made by non-cis white men here. Seems like the really cherry on top of bro cinema 2019. Also, whatever, burn it all. What the hell is bro cinema? Cinema these days is becoming diverse. There's a lot of women. There's a lot of colored people. If there's not, it gets called racist, misogynic, and it gets called out for being just that. So if anything, it's almost the opposite. Like Rian Johnson, who we all dislike, but as an example, Knives Out got called out for being all white. It's bad. But if it wasn't, if it was diverse, they would praise it. So it's exactly the opposite of what these people are saying is what's going on. I mean, I don't have a problem with anything as far as skin color, gender, or any of that bullshit, but my point is, the reality is, what's going on is opposite of what she's saying. I am very done arguing with white men on how the most qualified person should be hired to direct, write, produce, etc. in film versus non-white men being given opportunities. The systematic discrimination and hiring bias is real. Blah, blah, blah. If I'm of the opinion best person for the job, I guess because I'm white, that opinion's no longer valid. That's not a good opinion anymore in the world, like best person for the job. So a logical, common sense opinion, I guess, isn't good enough for her. But what if I wasn't white and I said it? What if somebody black said it? What if someone Chinese said it? Then I guess the same exact logic is right? Doesn't make sense, Michelle. That's why you're getting called crazy. But of course, not only racist comments, but sexist comments as well. Male footballers are babies every single match and fake being tackled all the damn time. Women celebrate their hard work and how they've busted their ass for less pay than the men, and suddenly they are like unsportsmanlike. They are literally the best in the game. Alright, I'm no sports guy, but I'm going to take a wild guess here that in the case of sports, in the specific case of sports, men's sports are much more popular and pull in much more money. So, look, female sports don't pull in as much money. They can't get paid as much. That's just a fact of life, okay? Sports fans are, again, I don't know, but I'm going to say majority men, okay? Look at any stadium on any given day. Look at the crowds. There are women there. Absolutely. You gals love sports. That's great. But the fact is, the majority of sports fans is men. And in the 1930s, I think, you know, baseball, when there was like wartime in the 20s or something, was led by women. There were women baseball teams because the men were out at war, and they didn't really pull in so much money. They didn't do so well. I mean, they were there to fill the space, but it just wasn't the same as men playing baseball. Again, like I said, I'm not a sports guy, but that seems like a fact of life to me. If I'm wrong, you guys let me know. If you guys are sports guys out there, let me know who the majority of the fans are. I'm taking this wild guess it's men. One day it was truly not a big deal, and TBH, if that fund is going to be more POC and minorities like, that's where it should be going to first. I'm still a white female and recognize the privilege that exists here, and I gotta keep saying things with labels. White, female, male, toxic, Democrat, Republican, label, label, label. So sick of these labels. I live in a world where we don't really have labels in the same way. Like, yes, people label each other here in Japan, but it's like, I see in the West, it's like label crazy. There's like a label for literally everything. Internet, can you keep a secret? My cousin is getting married this weekend. His girlfriend plus her side of the family are what I like to call South Boston racists. Ugh. I donated to Cairn National, whatever that is, and PPAF, blah, 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 in their name for their wedding gift. Off to NH. This will be fun this weekend. That plus threw me off right there. So I guess kids these days are using plus instead of spelling out P-L-U-S. An intellect, Michelle. You are a true, true intellect. And she also has a problem with Christians. I guess, I don't know, that's the new thing here. Not much religion in Japan. We don't even talk about it. We don't talk about, are you Christian, Jewish, Muslim? It does not exist here. You are just you. But apparently, in the West, there's a lot of talk about religion, and for some reason, social justice warriors don't like Christians. I'm trying to figure it out. I mean, Christians are all colors and races in this world, so I don't get it. I don't get what's with, you know, this putting down Christians. Please help me. Hey, Neil himself, seeing these two cosplay next to the angry Christians has been the best thing I've seen at SDCC so far. Where are the two angry Christians? Okay, okay, know the God of the Bible. Okay, I mean, sure. Sure, it's a Christian. Okay. That's what they do. They kind of walk around with signs about God. So what? They are crazy Christian whites from rural New England, so that's like our South, so it is just exhausting. I almost just punched a wall at their innocent until proven guilty post. Our fellow white women are the worst. White, 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 white. That's what I'm saying. So what does it have to do with, like, white being Christian? Christians are, like, literally everywhere. There's Christians in China, in India. There's Christians everywhere. But she's got to harp on white, 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 white. Maybe she doesn't like being white. Maybe, Michelle, change. Change races if you don't like it so much. Ichibaka points out bigotry with a definition with her comments. I'm not going to get that deep into it. But, you know, he does a really good job of breaking this down, and there's even more to it here. Here he is, Ichibaka, so yeah, I get a little cold. Maybe I'm like a little spacey in this one. I don't know, I think I'm getting through it pretty good. It's like 2 a.m. here. I gotta do this stuff when everyone's asleep. I know, it looks like I got this free time. I'm doing two videos a day, but it's a struggle. It's like in 1 hour, editing, thumbnail, pump it out, but I'm good. So click that subscribe button, smash it, whatever you want to do with it. Press it, at least just subscribe. You'll see more stuff. I'm uploading all the time, and I try to cover interesting things. Doesn't always work. Sometimes it does. Sometimes there's a reaction. Sometimes I mess up the end of the videos, and I say see you next time.